Another thing I've got to say though is that I still can't get my head around the fact that Wembley is packed out there, right? Like, right as I'm watching this, Wembley is sold out. And it's so easy for them four group of guys to just play as if they're playing a band practice. Like, there's thousands of people there. I don't know how he does it, man. Or they do it as well, not just Freddie, the whole band. On point as well, like, on point, perfect. I let breathe you choke in the future while the past bleeds. Death in the ring bells call for the deed. The fire, it don't let me down. Rewired. What up guys, David Jack. Welcome back to JackThatBack again. Yeah, it feels so nice to actually say that, man. I'm gonna be gone for about a week, but right now, this one was requested as soon as I released it. I done now on my ads, like the return video. And a lot of people say the live one on Wembley is really good for the energy and stuff. So today we're going to be reacting to Queen, Now I'm Here, live at Wembley. Yeah, we're returning to the live roots really because a lot of the stuff I've done back in the early days was all live stuff. So yeah, I'm looking forward to doing this one, Queen, Now I'm Here. If you'd like to support the channel, the link's in the description. Anything you can do means so much, so thank you, honestly. But anyways, let's do it, man. Queen, Now I'm Here. Look around. Sorry to interrupt straight away, but you know, honestly, you can tell from the get-go that no, since the last time he done it, like 10 years prior to this, his voice had improved. Like, it's got better with time. Like, I said that months ago as well about Freddie, that he got better as he got older as well. He just got better, more stronger. Sounds really nice, man. Like that little note there, and he goes around. Like, it sounds so much easier for him. I know it's not really a high note, but it just sounds so much cleaner and controlled. I don't know, like, it might just be me, but. Now I'm here. JackThatBack, man. It's always nice, I've seen it live, you know, get your blood pumping and the way he's jumping around and stuff. And Roger's drumming sounds amazing. Yeah, I'm so glad you can hear the drumming, like, really nice, because I've always loved the sound of an acoustic kit. I've always liked the sound of an acoustic kit. Just in general, I've said it loads of times on this channel, so yeah, I love acoustic drums like that. Amazing, all the energy's sick. Oh yeah! Live harmonies, man, they were fucking lovely as well. Jack back for that, cue it. Another thing I've got to say though is that I still can't get my head around the fact that Wembley is packed out there, right? Like, right as I'm watching this, Wembley is sold out. And it's so easy for them four group of guys to just play as if they're playing a band practice. Like, there's thousands of people there. I don't know how he does it, man. Or they do it as well, not just Freddie, the whole band. On point as well, like, on point, perfect. Jack are back again. Jack, yeah. Jesus. One thing I've got to say here, right, is that the key of this song, what I'm picking up anyway, the thing I'm picking up the most is Roger's drumming. Like, Roger's drumming had a chance to shine here. The way he's playing is just fucking insane. It's so good, man. It's so good. Speaking of drummers as well, I just want to say a massive rest in peace to Joey Jordison of Slipknot. Unfortunately, the drummer of Slipknot, the old drummer of Slipknot, Joey Jordison, passed away. So watching him and watching Roger on the drums and stuff is bringing back them good memories of when I first got into Slipknot as well. So I'm actually quite glad I'm reacting to this and the drums are a bit more emphasising the mix. Yeah, man, I really like it. So rest in peace, Joey Jordison. Can't even describe how I felt when I found out, man. But anyways, sorry to bring on a depressing topic there, but it's just like, it means a lot to me, so yeah. I'm in the dungeon, just pieces and me. Love that yeah there, that sounded so gritty. JackThatBack. Damn. Let's go. I think the reason that this is a fan favourite and all that, right? And probably Queen enjoyed playing it back in the day is because it's so workable. I would experiment and have some fun with it. I think that's probably why it's a fan favourite, because you can have so much fun with this song. You can switch it up as much as you want and stuff, because it's a very workable song, this. It's very off the cuff and you can kind of work with it and have fun with it. Really like it, man. I really like it. I'm hearing that bass, man. He is fucking going for it as well. John's feeling it. The thing is with John as well, he reminds us of me, because when he's playing something or he's into something, I don't think he's more of a facial features person, even though facial features do just naturally happen when you're into something. But he's really like down there, the guy, he's gritty, he's into it, like he's in his own world. Really like it, man. The bass is really shining as well. He's all the way halfway up the fretboard. Nice, man. There we go. That stage is fucking huge. Jesus. I thought Freddie was just going for a jog. He's literally going for a jog here. It's fucking huge, this place. Damn, man. I'm just picking up a little thing there, watch. He's just chilling. At this point, Freddie's just chilling, going, yeah, I'm just chilling. I'm going to let them make the magic for a little bit now. Now I'm going to come back in and add my sprinkle. You know what I mean? He's just chilling. Look at that. Look at it. He's just chilling. Like, he knows it's greatness. He knows what they're witnessing in the crowd is greatness as well. So he's just kind of like, yeah, that's us. JackThatBack. Jesus. Jeez. That's my new one. I say Jesus, but I like that one as well. I find it funny as well there, right? And that's why I love Queen, and especially Brian and Freddie's relationship. When Brian started turning up the heat on the guitar work, that's when Freddie went from standing there just waving and going, yeah, 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 to like going, oh shit, this is hard. And he starts bopping around again. If you look at it properly, watch. There we go. Now that he's back. Now he's back, you see. I really, really love the drums in this mix. The drums sound fucking class, honestly. Damn, damn, did he hear that? Jack Batman. Jack, yeah. Again, like I said yesterday, yeah, I've done that, Freddie, and all of yous have done that, Queen. All of yous. But Freddie, yes you have. Yes you have. Damn, drive back. Jump, yeah. I've missed them classic Freddie notes. Yeah. I think I'll stay around, 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 around. Around. Damn. Jesus, that's so haunting. Jump back again. Jump, yeah. Damn. It's, I don't know if it's because of the fact of the stadium aesthetics or something, but that's haunting, man. That, the echo in the ears and that, like, that's really nice, man. That 80s reverb, you'll never beat the 80s reverb, you know, it really brought out your vocals. I think I'll stay around, 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 around. Damn. Damn! Jeez! Jab back again. Jab, yeah. Wasn't expecting that. Down in the city, just for you and me. Jesus! Damn! and they just walk off. Like nothing. Like nothing. As per McQueen, though, innit? Damn, man. I don't know what to say. I honestly don't know what to say, man. Again, like I always do now, I never know what to say about Queen after I've watched the performance. Like, it's not even a performance, it's more of an experience when you listen to Queen. You get sucked into that world and it's not even like a performance, it's an experience, like I say, it's like a drug. Honestly, Queen is like a drug. But that drumming, the thing I like the most on there, everything sounded good, don't get us wrong, but like that drumming really stood out in this mix on this one. And gladly so, because Roger doesn't get the credit. Honestly, like, he just doesn't. Like, he's known as, he was in Queen, and he's still known as like a big, big person in the music industry, but as for his skills, his drumming skills are fucking on point. I think in the 80s, it was Freddie Mercury, it was all about Freddie Mercury on it, so there's even videos still coming out now about how many octaves he could go up and that, so it's understandable why Freddie was the most talked about, you know what I mean? So, honestly though, Roger's drumming, fucking top notch on this one, man. And it always has been, but I'm really glad that it shined during this one. And it was louder on the mix. I really liked it because he was going apeshit with them drums, man. And it just brings back a lot of good memories of watching old Slipknot videos and stuff. So yeah, once again, rest in peace to Joey Jordison, man. Absolute trailblazers on the metal industry. But anyways, thanks for watching the video, guys. Hope you enjoyed it. And I've done the one that you requested. So yeah, thanks for watching. I'll see you next time. And peace.